one, and a two, and a one, two, three.
Mona Lisa.
Here's one of you. Here's one of Garfield.
Okay.
Your favorite cat.
And her Garfield.
Oh. You might have shot all the films.
I'm usually a little retro with my stuff. I think being from Winnipeg, I think I say this a lot, but it peaked in the 1920s, and I kind of got that ghost of the 1920s in my art. Seeing my son make art, it's just exciting to see him discover like his creativity. And he saw me making art, and I'd always have spare paper supplies and paints for him ready. His favorite thing was to come to the studio and just hang out. He just kind of had free reign of playing with whatever.
How early on did you start drawing?
Pretty early, like a really early age. I was into coloring books, and then I just kind of ran out of coloring books and I drew my own stuff. If I'm under camera pressure, I'll go to things that I've done before. I could put a bat there or something. They did a demonstration online somewhere of how to draw a bat.
Hi everyone, I'm Marcel Dzama, and I'm gonna show you how to draw a bat. So usually I start with a head.
What I have so far.
So do you typically start with sketches?
Yeah, I'll usually sketch out something. I have a scrapbook. I have like a regular scrapbook, and then sometimes they publish them. This is more of a storyboard, though, for the film. Dracula in C minor. Oh, I guess they could cut to it, even.
Cut! 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 Freeze! What is the deal with the lighting? We need more light. And Smokey, what's the deal with all the extra smoke? I can barely see my dancer's crotches.
This image of a ballerina I found, and then just altered it to one of my characters. Just the pose looked really great. And then I have a 21-year-old cat. And he looks really rough. And so he kind of looks like the sinister cat that's in here.
What's your cat's name?
Pip. It's P-I-P.
Has your son gotten into painting?
So this must be there's older stuff of his up here. And this one, he was really young and he did it. He did Bugs Bunny.
Wow, that's really good.
Yeah. It was the one time he penciled it first and then filled it in. And this one, he added arrows to it.
Wow, cool.
But he was really happy to write his name on a reel. This is for London. So instead of drawing it, I just decided to paint straight on. Because usually I do pencil first. This one I was doing more of a kind of a messy painting version.
Do you have a central theme to this upcoming London show?
Yeah, I was thinking of kind of placing a slight environmental message in there that like usually is a lot of flooding in the drawings, but they're kind of relaxed still. A little bit of apocalypse in this paradise.
Lonjar, do you copy? Lonjar, do you copy?
So this is how I communicate with my alien parents in Winnipeg. Here's the studio. Working on some masks and some potheads. Yeah, I think I made like a stage that I'm gonna put them on, not a chess set. I kind of stopped playing when my son was born because I just didn't have time. now he started playing, so we play together. But I really lost my skills. That's a Willem drawing. Yeah, this one was trying to do a messy painting, but kind of keep it together, like just kind of as wet as possible.
So what's your current workflow?
It's been pretty much nocturnal still, but not as late as it was, because my son is school now, so I really need to switch onto the normal schedule. But the ideas seem to flow better at night.
Have you landed on a title for this piece?
Midnight's Child, I think. Yeah, I was kind of just drawing late at night. And I had Willem up too. Maybe I'll add a couple colors here or there.
What are the materials you used for this piece?
I was using this as kind of pearlescent acrylic paint. And then also this watercolor. Yeah, endorsement. I did that other one in that style too, the kind of extra wet stuff. Garfield went through a change. This was the day the queen died, and I painted a version of the queen that was on my grandma's biscuit tin. It was like these old British biscuit tin, or maybe Canadian, I don't know. My dad would always make things. He was really into medieval knights and things like that. So he made armor, and he used to make little lead knights and paint them. When I started in art school, I did short films. Those are the ones my dad and my sister starred in. My sister would always smile or laugh while she's being filmed. So that's when I started making paper mache masks, so I could have all these different characters. Also, I was out of actors because there'd just be those two, so they could play different characters as well.
How did you introduce your son to what you do for a living?
He just always saw it, and he's so creative.
Has he ever talked about what he wants to be when he grows up?
Yeah, he wanted to be a marine biologist, and then he does want to be an artist too. He could be both, I guess, yeah. And he really likes making films. He likes dressing up in costumes and stuff and making costumes. Yeah, I feel like during the pandemic, it was really, that's when we collaborated a lot. This one, kind of this whole series of underwater drawings that I've been doing, it kind of has that midnight feel where it's like the moon over a body of water. I also drew the one of those fish that my son caught. Robin fish, I think it's called. He's the one that tells me all my green biology stuff. Sorry, pal, but game's over.
You take the cane?
Yeah. You crowbar the door open.
Yeah.
Like the crowbar.
Yeah.
Okay.
Do you help your dad in the studio much?
Yeah.
What sort of stuff do you do in
there? Gold dots?
Yeah.
He spilled a bunch of black paint on one of my drawings by accident. I actually like the way it looked because it was so random.
So how many more works do you have to complete for the London show?
I got an extension, so that was good because I didn't finish one of the large ones. And then I have to do, either I'm going to put them all together or I think I'm going to do a triptych, like two triptychs. So this is one kind of similar to the ones I did for the subway drawing. And I got Willem to put, did you put dots on this one? I can't remember. Where did you put the dots, Willem?
Does this piece have a name?
Here Comes the Sun. but spelt sun as in...
S-O-N.
As in Willem. But there's a bat with a baby bat. I guess it's nursing it. I don't know if they actually nurse or not. Can you see the tape?
Yep.
Just pull it. Yeah. Thank you. This will be like an underwater scene. Oh, I should have brought the... I was drawing these from...
the yellow one?
Yeah. Where'd you get that? It was at a...
I think it was at the aquarium.
Yeah.
When I went there on a field trip.
So you're going to be a marine biologist, Willem?
No? No. Not anymore? What do you want to be now? You don't have to decide now. Artist? Okay. Yeah, well... Well, thanks.
Oh, wow. Pretty cool.
It's a cinder block we spray painted and the barbecue we spray painted.
What is that?
See that guy? That's the bear. That guy? That's me. Do you expect it to get killed in it? Book here's me when I was a kid, or 20 something. 23. Kid to me.
I don't really know what people find in my artwork. Like, I know what I see in it, but I basically just seems the humor seems to kind of strike a chord with most people.
Not bad, considering that not that long ago he was selling doodles for a dollar a piece.
A dollar a doodle.
A dollar a doodle.
The dollar doodle guy.
Marcel Dzama is an amazingly productive artist, with a way of drawing that can be both lyric and rude at the same time. His drawing world is full of compelling characters.
Like, it's the greatest job in the world, really. It's like, I don't have to have a real job. It's a form of this is really not.
Please clap now. Thank you. Thank you.